Good morning, dear students. So today we shall begin with chapter number 8, quadrilateral constructions and types. Now in this chapter, you can see this, let's recall. This part is totally deleted. Okay, so all these 4 questions are deleted here. Now let us see what do we mean by a quadrilateral. We all know that a quadrilateral is a 4-sided figure which has got 4 angles, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 sides, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 2 diagonals. So in all, there are 10 elements of each quadrilateral. So each quadrilateral has 4 angles, 4 sides and 2 diagonals. So from these 10 elements, we are going to learn how to construct the various types of quadrilaterals based on the information given. Now, let's learn construction of a quadrilateral. We can construct a quadrilateral if we know the measures of some specific 5 elements out of 10. Constructions of triangles are the basis of the constructions of quadrilaterals. So this, let's learn how to draw first type of construction. To construct a quadrilateral, of if the lengths of the 4 sides and a diagonal is given. Now here, let us construct quadrilateral PQRS such that length PQ is equal to 5.6, length QR is equal to 5 centimeters, length PS is 4.3, length SR or RS is equal to 7 centimeters and 6.2 is QS is the diagonal. Okay, so let us see how to construct it. So first you have to always draw, you have to draw a rough figure for this. So I have already drawn a rough figure over here. So based on the information, I will draw the fair figure. So now here you can see that. So first let us draw 6.2, the diagonal. Okay. So here you take your pencil, a sharp pencil and a scale and draw 6.2. So let us label this as S and Q segment, 6.2 centimeters. Now let us draw SR 7 centimeters. So here with the help of a rounder on the scale, you will measure 7 centimeters. Okay, so here you will measure 7 centimeters. Okay, so this is 7. So here I'll keep it on point S and draw an arc here. Okay, this is 7 centimeters. Now next is RQ, which is 5 centimeters. So here with the help of the rounder, I'll take 5 centimeters here, keep the pointer on Q and cut the first arc. Right, now let us join these 2 points. So let me write here 7 centimeters and this is 5 centimeters. Okay, now let us draw these 2 segments now. SP is 4.3. So again, let me take SP as 4.3. Yeah. So keep it the pointer on S, draw an arc here. Again, this is 5.6. So let me take it as 5.6 on the rounder. Okay, so let's join these 2 segments. So let me label this as 5.6 centimeter and this as 4.3 centimeters. Now I have drawn it like this. You can even draw this vertically. You can take this SQ as up here like this, 6.2, and again you can change it. You can label this as the other way, either clockwise or anti-clockwise. You can say here PQRS. You can draw that type of figure also. That is also correct. So I hope you have followed the first construction in which four sides, 1, 2, 3, four sides, and one diagonal is given here. Okay, now let us move on to the second type of construction, in which you have to draw based on the information given to you. As to construct a quadrilateral, if three sides and two diagonals are given to you. Now here, construct quadrilateral W, X, Y, Z such that length YZ is equal to 4 centimeters, length ZX is equal to 6 centimeters, length WX is equal to 4.5 centimeters, length WZ is equal to 5 centimeters, length YW is equal to 6.5. So here two diagonals are given. Okay, so we will draw a rough figure, and based on that we will construct a quadrilateral. Okay, so now here I have already drawn a rough figure here. Okay, so now based on this, see here, based on this information, we will draw a quadrilateral. So first, let us draw ZW as 5 centimeters. So this is ZW, 5 centimeters. Then ZY is 4 centimeters. So let me take 4 centimeters on the scale. And keep it on Z. Draw one arc here. Okay. Now next, WX is 4.5. So let me keep the scale and take this as 4.5. Little bit more. Yes. Yeah. So from here, I'll take 4.5. Now, this diagonal is 6 centimeters. So let me take 6 centimeters again. You can see here on the scale. And cut this arc. Okay. Let's cut this arc here. Yeah. So let me join this here. First, let me join this here. This is 6 centimeters, right? Now, another one. This is 6.5 centimeters. So let me again take 6.5 centimeters. Yeah, 6.5 centimeters. And draw here. Now here, let me join this here. Okay, so this is 6.5. Now this segment we have to join. This is 4.5 centimeters. Let us join this here, both arcs cutting, and again let's join this here. So here this is 4 centimeters. So here this is the required quadrilateral. You can draw this like this, or you can even change this. You can put this here 6.5 centimeters as this diagonal and this diagonal here. So you have to change according to the names. You have to change that clockwise or anti-clockwise. Anyway, you can take Z here, Z, Y, X, W. Anyhow, you can label it accordingly. That diagram is also correct. Even if you take Z here, anywhere you take. But you have to take the measurements accordingly and draw. So I hope you understood this construction where three sides and two diagonals are given. Now, let us go to the third type of construction. To construct a quadrilateral, if two adjacent sides and three angles are given. Adjacent means next to each other. See, these two sides are next to each other. These two sides actually are given. Actually, they are also called as included sides. Okay, so three angles are given. So here we have to draw this base, then accordingly draw these two angles, the sides, and draw this angle, and we can draw it. So let us see the third type of construction, in which three angles are given and two adjacent sides are given to you. So let us draw that. Now first we draw a rough figure. So LE is 4.5, EF is 5.5, angle L is 60, E is 100 and F is 120. So first let us draw LE as 4.5. So let us take LE as 4.5. LE 4.5 centimeters. Now with the help of a protractor, we will be measuring the angle L. So we'll keep it here like this. You know now the zero of the inner scale is coinciding. So we will take the inner scale up to 60 degrees. So here. Okay. So I'll just draw this. Right. This is 60 degrees. Now E is 100 degrees. So again I will keep the protractor here. At this edge, at the point E. And now the outer scale. I have to measure from the outer scale. So here you get 100 degrees here. Okay. I'll just draw this. Now here EF is 5.5. So on the scale we'll measure 5.5 and cut an arc. Yeah. So it is 5.5. So here I'll cut an arc. Label this as E, point E. And here this is 120 degrees. So let us keep the paper like this. Okay. And now you can measure 120 degrees. So let us measure 120 degrees on this. Now here, see this outer scale, we'll be using it. 120 degrees is here. Okay. So we did not extend it so far, but yeah, over here. Okay, so this is intersecting at this point. So we will say this E is 120 degrees. So this is the required quadrilateral. Yes, this is 5.5 centimeters. This is 100 degrees. So you can draw it like this also. Even if you take this here also doesn't matter. But you have to accordingly label it. Okay. So angle L, wherever L is, you have to take 60. E will be 100. Sorry, this is E. This is F. This is F. Label this as F. Okay. So here accordingly you can draw the diagram. Yes. You can draw the diagram accordingly. It's correct. All will be correct. Use arcs. Now, let us go to the fourth type of construction in which to construct a quadrilateral, if three sides and two angles included by them are given. Now, here you can see three sides. 1, 2, 3. And the two angles, angle S75 and angle R62 are given. So they are included. They are included in between. That's why they are called as included angles. So we will see how to construct this based on the information given. So draw a rough figure always as usual. So QR is 5 centimeters. SR is 6.2 centimeters. PS is 4 centimeters. R angle is 62 degrees. And S is 75 degrees. So let us draw based on this. So first you draw QR as 5 centimeters. Then first let us take 62 degrees. Okay, R, angle R. Again the outer scale is going to coincide with this. So here 62 degrees. 62 degrees. So here, yeah, this is 62 degrees. Now this is 6.2 centimeters. So on the scale, I will take 6.2 centimeters. Yeah, 6.2. So I'll just connect it. So this is your point S, and this you have to take as 75 degrees. So I will keep it like this. Okay, let me keep it like this. I hope you can see. Yes, now let me measure 75 degrees. So here we'll keep the protractor like this exactly. Now the zero of the outer scale. So here. So let's connect this. Okay. And just join this point also here. Okay. Now, sorry, this should be 4 centimeters. This is 6.2 centimeters. This is 75 degrees, and this should be 4. So let us take 4 centimeters first and then draw it. First let's take 4 centimeters on the scale. Yeah, so here I will take 4 centimeters from this point. Yeah, and draw this. So here So let me join this here, 4 centimeters, and here connect this here. So this is 4 centimeters, this is point P, this is point S. So I hope you have understood this construction. So you can draw all the various types of constructions. Now let us go to the exercise. Let us see the exercise in which I will solve two problems and the other two you will solve it at home. Yeah. So the first one, the construction. Construct the following. So here, construct the following quadrilaterals of the given measure. In quadrilateral MORE, length MO is 5.8 centimeters. Length OR is 4.4 centimeters. Measure angle M is 58 degrees. Measure angle O is 105 degrees. Measure angle R is 90 degrees. First draw a rough figure and then draw. Three angles are given to you. Next, second one. Construct quadrilateral DEFG such that length DE is 4.5 centimeters. Length EF is 6.5 centimeters. Length DG is equal to 5.5 centimeters. Length DF is equal to 7.2 centimeters. Length EG is 7.8 centimeters. Now the third one, in quadrilateral ABCD, length AB is 6.4, length BC is 4.8 centimeters, angle A is 70 degrees, angle B is 50 degrees, and angle C is 140 degrees. So let me draw the third one and show you. So I have already drawn a rough figure here. So here, okay. So let us label this as angle. This is your angle C. This is your 6.4 is AB. 6.4 is AB here, then BC is 4.8 and this is D here. So here angle A is 70 degrees, angle B is 50 degrees, angle C is 140 degrees. Now based on this information, let us construct the triangle. Okay, so first we will draw 6.4 centimeters. AB segment is 6.4 centimeters. Now, angle A is 70 degrees. So, angle A is 70 degrees. So, we'll take the inner scale, 0. Over here. So, let me draw this. Yeah. Now, next. Angle B is 50 degrees. So let me take angle B as 50 degrees. Here. And this should be 4.8 8 centimeters. So let me take 4.8 centimeters on the scale first. So here, so this is 50 degrees, this is your 70 degrees, this is 4.8 centimeters. Okay, now this point C, it has to be 140 degrees. So let us keep it like this and draw it. Okay. So here you can see, degrees means here it has to go with the outer scale. So here 20, 30, 40, it has to be 140 degrees. So here it is 140. So let me draw a line like this. Yes, so here this is 140 degrees. So here you can see . So this is the required quadrilateral. This is the required quadrilateral. Now you can change this. You can take A here, B here, C here, D here. And then accordingly you will draw the quadrilateral. Anyway, or A you can take here, B here, C here, D here. All are correct. You can draw it accordingly. Okay. So now let us go to the fourth question. Construct quadrilateral LMNO such that length LM is equal to length LO equal to 6 centimeters. Length ON equal to length NM 4.5 centimeters. And length OM is equal to 7.5 centimeters. Now this quadrilateral can be drawn in two different ways. So let us see how to draw it. Okay. So the first type in which I have drawn the rough figure in which the diagonal is horizontal like this. So first let us draw this 7.5 centimeters, okay, OM is 7.5 centimeters. Now, ON and OM are 4.5. So, what I'll do on the scale, I'll take 4.5 centimeters. Yeah, so here I'll keep on pointer on O and cut one arc here. Another one, I'll keep on point M, cut one arc. Now join these two points. Label this point as N. This is 4.5 centimeters. This is also 4.5 centimeters. Now, these two are 6 centimeters. So again, on the scale, I'll measure 6 centimeters. Yeah, so keep the pointer on O and draw one arc. Similarly, keep the pointer on O here, M here, and draw an arc. So this is 6 centimeters and this is also 6 centimeters. So this is the required quadrilateral. Now, another alternative method is that you can draw it like this. This diagonal, you can draw it like this. So, accordingly, we will draw the figure. This another method. This is also correct. So, first, let me draw the base LO as 6 centimeters. So, first, or we can draw a diagonal also. Let's draw the diagonal first, 7.5 centimeters. Okay, we'll draw a diagonal 7.5 centimeters. Diagonal M and O as 7.5 centimeters. Now, these two sides are 6 centimeters. So, let us take 6 centimeters. Yeah, we already have them. So, from point O, I'll draw an arc. And point M also, I'll draw an arc. Now join these two sides. This is 6 centimeters. This is 6 centimeters. Okay, this is point N. Okay, now these two sides are 4.5, 4.5. So let's take on the scale 4.5. Yeah. So again from point M, 4.5, point O also 4.5. And let us join these two. So this is your point N. This is 4.5 centimeters. And this is also 4.5 centimeters. So both these are correct. You can draw any one of them. So I hope you have followed the constructions well. Draw only the two remaining constructions, first and second, and revise for the unit test 1. In the next video, you will be seeing the revision of the chapters 1 and 3. Okay, so study well. Best of luck.